No. I think it's getting worse.
House meeting in 5 minutes.
Best.
It won't take long. There's a few things we need to discuss.
Fine.
Already made my decision.
Well, Luke has more to say, I guess. Where's Sarah?
She's got a book. She doesn't need to be a part of it.
You're not supposed to be in here. Hi. Can you please help me? I'm not supposed to talk to you. My dad can't know. What are you reading?
A book.
What book? I like books. It's called The Gurgles. It's about transdimensional body snatchers. Cool. What happened to you?
A dog bit me.
Sounds scary. I bet it hurts. You want to see it?
It really wasn't one of them.
It really wasn't.
Ew, gross.
I know, right?
You have to bandage it, like my dad does.
Yeah, I know. Help me. I need something to clean it with. Bandages. And I need to sew some of it up. It's too deep.
My dad says we're out of real bandages. But I know where to get something to clean it. That's what this supplies.
I'll help you.
Good.
Thank you.
Sarah.
I'm Clementine. We're friends, right? We can be best friends. I haven't met another girl my age since way before. It's hard to be the only girl, you know? Rebecca is okay, but she's old. And that's it. And if her baby is a girl, it'll be forever before she's old enough to, like, be my friend. And then I'll be super.
Yes, we are friends.
Promise? It's important. Friends have to trust each other, no matter what. Do you promise or not? Alright, fine. I get it. I can't promise.
No, I'm sorry.
If I help you, will you leave me alone? I don't want to get in trouble. I'll get the stuff my dad uses when I get a cut. I think this is it.
That'll work.
You can't out here, though. Someone will find you.
Don't worry. I won't. Thanks, Sarah. Still need some bandages, though. They have to have medical supplies around here somewhere. Exactly bandages, but they should help stop the bleeding. This is gonna suck. Fun part. Now, just like last time, just how Krista showed me.
Did he get in here?
Little girl's tough as nails.
Are you all right?
The shed should have been safe.
Are you happy? I could have died, you know.
Well, you didn't.
I just needed some help.
You patched yourself up?
Where'd you get that stuff?
Did she steal from us?
This doesn't change a thing. She hasn't done anything to us.
Says the man not carrying a baby.
Enough already.
You left me no choice.
You could have just left.
Relax, Rebecca.
Bring her in, and I'll take a look at her arm.
Damn lurker sneaking around out here. We better get inside.
You hungry?
This might hurt a little.
Ow!
How's she look?
Her suturing skills need some work, but otherwise, I say she should be fine.
So, it wasn't a lurker bite?
If it was, the fever would have already set in, and her temperature would be through the roof. I wish you wouldn't have done what you did.
What do you mean?
You manipulated my daughter.
I asked for her help.
She's not someone you can just ask for help. I'll give you the benefit of the doubt, but there are a few things you need to know about my daughter.
Okay.
She isn't like you. You may not get that initially, but once you're around her for a while, you'll understand. If she knew how bad the world is, what it's really like out there, she would cease to function. She's my little girl. She's all I have left, and I would ask that you stay away from her.
You don't have to threaten me.
Rebecca was worried you might be working with someone else, that your being here was no accident. I guess we'll find out. But one thing I know for sure, you are not to be trusted. Stay away from my daughter.
Hey, brought you some food if you're hungry. That's gonna leave one hell of a scar.
Better than losing it.
You can say that again. Scars? They're way cooler than stumps.
Definitely.
Hey, look. I just want to say I'm sorry for being a dick out there. Got kind of aggro. That was definitely not cool. Nick's been known to go off every once in a while. Don't hold it against him.
Yeah, I guess we all have our moments.
You definitely had one out there.
You were just protecting your friends. I get it.
I didn't mean to be so harsh. I just... we had a bad experience once.
All had bad experiences.
Nick lost his mom. We took care of someone who got bit.
It was my fault.
It was no one's fault. We thought we could control it, but we couldn't. And then she turned, and his mom was standing right there, and she got attacked. And there was nothing we could do about it.
Anyway, hopefully you understand.
I do.
So, since you're pretty much on your own, what's your plan?
Maybe I could stay here for a little bit, if that's all right.
I've got no problem with it.
Do you think everyone else will be okay with it?
Well, they'll just have to deal. Besides,
it makes sense to let you heal and take some time to sort things out, at least for a little while. So, what happened to your parents? If you don't mind me asking. I mean, I assume what happened to them is what happened to just about everyone's parents. You're just so young. Didn't think you could have made it on your own for so long, but maybe you did.
Other people took care of me, if that's what you're asking.
I was just curious on how you made it this far.
I just tried to stay with good people and not do anything dumb.
Hey, I'm sorry. I shouldn't have asked.
My parents went on vacation and left me with a babysitter. But they never came back. We went to Savannah to find them.
I'm sorry to hear that.
This man found me and took care of me. We met up with other survivors and we all tried to make it. But it didn't work. His name was Lee. He taught me how to survive. He's the reason I keep my hair short.
What?
Same thing that happens to everyone, but he saved me first, lots of times.
Well, it sounds like he was a real good guy.
Yeah, he was.
I hate to interrupt, but I'm out there standing watch and I can't help but notice this place is lit up like a goddamn beacon in the middle of the woods.
Yeah, it's time to turn in anyways.
Now get your winks while you can, because we're going fishing at first light. Couple fresh brookies for dinner. Wouldn't that be nice?
Oh, you're still here. I wouldn't be comfortable if I were you.
Luke invited me to stay.
Good for him. But that's not how things work around here. We make decisions as a group, and you're wearing out your welcome. You got what you came here for. Now go.